I was born a handful from Nashville, Tennessee, where all year long the summer breezes flow. And one of my friends are flying kites and planting bonsai trees. I got high on country radio.
Singapore Cowboy was a song that I enjoyed particularly because of the lyrics. I felt that it was a very honest song about Matthew's life, about how he fell in love with country music, and he had proudly referenced the fact that it was odd, but it didn't matter. He was just doing what he loved, and he made it work for himself.
Bright stars and guitars, but not on my own. Singapore cowboy, where do I belong? Won't you sing a hook cowboy in the
There's no one in Singapore, even now or back then, that play country music. So that what makes Matthew stand up from the rest of the bands that we have in Singapore.
I find that Matthew has a very soothing voice, a voice that you can actually listen, and you know, even if you don't dance, you know.
I think it's a country songs more smooth, more slow. Slow, then a lot of senior citizen people, they can dance. Not set the music, hot music, very fast. A lot of senior citizen, they cannot make it in the fast step.
He is so good that he's comparable to people like Dave Sherriff and even George Strait.
I've never seen a Chinaman could sing a country music song.
Matthew, it's a real pleasure to meet you, and thank you so much for speaking with me today.
My pleasure.
Now, Matthew, I've uncovered a lovely photo of you from not very long ago, it would seem, because you seem to look exactly the same as you do now.
Oh, thank you. That's my first album with EMI, 1978.
Right. Called Matthew and the Mandarins.
That's right.
Uh-huh. And this picture was taken
in the Singapore Turf Club. It was raining, and you know, you can see my hair was a little wet.
Your hair does look slightly moist. Yeah, yes, but still very handsome. Could you tell us how it first started for you?
I was actually in a church choir that was taught by the late emeritus Archbishop, and I always remember that he says, sing with your head voice, not with the throat voice.
Right.
And I guess I was so into music and singing that whatever he tells me, then he says, you know, diction, pronunciation, and all these things. So I took it to heart.
So you progressed from choir boy to cowboy. That must have been quite a change. Now, what exactly about country music was it that appealed to you as a young boy growing up?
It is a good feeling, you know. Although, literally, I may not be actually experiencing the same thing. But eventually, somehow, something might be related to your lifestyle. You know, like, you know, you see Loretta Lynn's song, Coal Miner's Daughter. I don't exactly grow up that way, but we know how it is to be poor. Yeah, I live in Upper Serangoon, which is a real ulu place, you know, atop houses, and you cannot be any more country than that, you know. When I was actually doing gigs and functions at that time, a lot of my musician friends used to tease me and actually disturb me, you know, and hit me, say, call me Hank Tan. Yeah, because of Hank Williams, you know. First function, I remember I played for my guitarist friend, one of his old girlfriends, birthday party, right, in somewhere in Katong.
That was your first professional gig.
And $35
for the whole band.
Yeah, we didn't care about the money. We just wanted to go there and play and meet girls.
When did you turn into Matthew and the Mandarins?
One evening when we were discussing with the general manager, the MD of the Goodwood Group, he asked me this question and said, would you all wear Mandarin uniforms? They delivered to us, it was actually the long, those long gowns, you know, those like chong something, but right, loose one,
right,
men.
Right, right.
And then with a small little vest, you know, red, pink, you know, all those brocade, the silk, you know. So, oh my goodness, you know, I didn't even bargain for that, you know, I did. It's hard to move, you know, to climb on stage, we might fall down, you know. So, but anyway, you know, they had a MC, a British, English guy, to do the introduction before we came out. I did not know it. I didn't even know that he was going to introduce us. He, you know, talk about Confucius. It says, Confucius says, men in skirts run faster than ladies. So actually, I was shocked, you know, I came up, yeah, the Mandarins.
That's how he introduced you?
Yeah, he didn't tell us that we were going to change the name. He said Mandarins, you know, so you know, nobody else. Ooh. So we went, you know, we just started singing, you know. I sang my songs in Singapore, and crazy as it seems, a distant show kept calling after me. And 10 years from my first guitar, I gathered all my dreams, and here I am in Nashville, Tennessee. I left Singapore in 1975. I have always wanted to go to Nashville to get closer to the music that I loved. Yeah. In 1975, I decided, you know, I've saved enough. I'm a bachelor. I have no commitment anywhere. You know, so it was a good time for me to just pull my roots out and just go. I had no intention. I did not know exactly how long I was going to stay there or what I was going to do.
Just wait.
Just go and find out what I can do.
So Matthew, you sang at the Midnight Jamboree as part of the Grand Ole Opry, which
yes,
is it's a radio.
Yeah, it's on the WSM radio station.
Yeah. And you were invited to join them to perform and sing on this.
Right.
What was that experience like?
It's actually a once-in-a-lifetime kind of thing. Mm. Like, this gentleman is known as Ernest Tubb. He is known as a Texas troubadour. He has this show, this is a syndicated show that he has been running for years and years, you know, and he was responsible for giving breaks to people like Loretta Lynn, the Wilburn Brothers, all these big country stars, names who got this beginning from him, you know. Even Elvis Presley appeared on the show.
Oh my goodness.
It was all these big names were there. After I finished, you know, some people, you know, hey, where do you learn to speak English like that? You know? And I said, Singapore is a British colony, you know, was a British colony. We were taught by the British how to speak English, you know. They thought, you know, maybe I'm miming or I'm phonetically using something, you know, to pretend to sing, you know.
Yeah, there's a song here on side one on this vinyl, obviously, called Singapore Cowboy, which obviously is a song that you are synonymous with. Could you give us a little background on that song?
Well, I stayed in this motel called Anchor Motel, and working there was a night auditor. His name was Bristol Harper. He was the night auditor there, and I stayed there and met talked with him, and through our conversation, I found out that he was also a struggling songwriter, and I relate to him, you know, how I came to Nashville and why I came, and told him about my background, whatever. So I said, well, why don't you write some song about, you know, this thing about me. I said I get asked many times by people, how are you getting into this music? Why are you getting into the music? And all these questions, I said, why don't we just put it in a song about me and just tell him what I do, you know? And that's how, you know, I related to him. I told him about how I, you know, when my friends are all playing kites and whatever, and I was into my music, you know, and so.
So with all,
yeah, when I'll tell him this, the next day he came up with the words of Singapore Cowboy. Exactly, nothing was changed. When I read it, I said, goodness, he put my whole life story in just two verses and a chorus. You know, because when I read it, I said, wow. You know, I was born a half a world away.
But
you know?
The melody, who came up with the, the melody?
When he gave it to me, I said, wow, it is so accurate, you know.
Yeah.
So I took my guitar. Within 5 minutes, I got my song all done for him. And because I come from the East, Oriental, so I thought, you know, why don't I just give it a few Chinese melody? So what I did was I told him, I said, we're going to start off with.
So, Matthew, you took all these experiences and eventually came back to Singapore.
Yes.
What was the reason for that?
Well, the reason, I tried so very hard to get my musicians to come. You know, I didn't want to form a band with the US musicians because you lose that novelty, you know. And I want all of us to look, the chinkos to go down there and, you know, and create a little bit of notice, you know. But I couldn't, so I came back. And when I came back, EMI, you know, people say, hey, you wrote the song there, we want to hear you sing. So I said, okay, you know, we recorded the album. And actually, I did not know that I was going to record Singapore Cowboy. Then Reggie Burgess was our producer. He says, hey, Cowboy, Singapore Cowboy, where? I said, are you sure? I said, people will laugh at you, you know, there's no cowboy in Singapore. You know, no, you must record that. That's the reason why. He said, your song is so popular. Then I said, okay, you know, I was skeptical, you know. I said, okay, you know, you insist I record for you. So we recorded the song.
It was a hit.
And that was it. And yeah, it went, well, you know, it started off at number 9 in the charts here. And I went to number 5. I said, oh, that's it, you know. Then it went to number 4. Finally, from 4, it jumped to number 1.
Wow.
Then I just could not believe it.
So Matthew, how do you feel about being the one and only bona fide Singapore country musician?
Well, you know, I will just be happy if people remember me as a true lover of country music who sings from the heart. You know, who has a lot of love and don't do it strictly for money, you know. I enjoy, genuinely enjoy singing for people, you know, and that's what I like to do best, you know, even till today, you know. I was born a half a world from Nashville, Tennessee, where all year long the summer breezes blow. And while my friends are flying kites and planting bonsai trees, I got high on country radio. It wasn't long before a song was born inside my heart, and soon I started singing right along. An understanding uncle smiling gave me my first start by listening to my Shanghai country songs. Singapore cowboy, so far from my home. Bright stars and guitars, but none of my own. Singapore cowboy, where do I belong? Won't you sing a poor cowboy another lonely song?
Excellent.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was great. Love it. Sing it.